Welcome back to the Plus Side of Nashville. I'm so excited to have joining me now Lisa Quinn, decorator extraordinaire.
Thank you.
You brought some really gorgeous fall ideas, things we can do to put a little touch of fall in our homes. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Well, I always love having you because you inspire me and I get so many great tips from you.
Thank you.
Let's start with your pumpkins here because you have really turned an ordinary pumpkin into something pretty extraordinary.
You know, a lot of people are painting pumpkins and spray painting pumpkins, and that's great. There's lots of great painting ideas, but I love to decoupage. I think it's almost a lost art. I used to decoupage all the time, but here I have ferns in my yard.
Yeah.
So if you're going to do these, you're going to have to press them.
Okay.
And I don't know if they're. Do they still have phone books?
I don't know. I think some people may just have some around. But
you can use a book, press them before you decoupage them.
Okay.
And for anyone that hasn't decoupaged, all you need is a brush and something called Mod Podge.
Okay.
Which you must have the Mod Podge. And this, the white one with the glitter, that is an image I cut out of a napkin.
That cocktail napkin. That's a great idea. That's from a cocktail napkin. Mm-hmm. That is so great.
And it needed a little punch, so I put a little glitter on it.
So do you just take the cutout piece, put it on the pumpkin, and then paste over with the decoupage?
I put a little Mod Podge under it so it sticks well, and it's going to look really weird. But when it dries, it won't look weird.
Because I can't even tell you have anything on it.
It looks like white glue.
Okay.
To your eye, but you just keep on. It doesn't matter how much you put on there. Put as much on there until it sticks well.
Okay.
And when it dries, it'll dry clear.
Oh, I love that. And then this little tiny, I was just telling you, I spent money on something that I could have actually done myself.
Well, that is a really great gold metallic paint, my Rust-Oleum. And if you don't want, I just spray painted a few things.
Uh-huh.
If you don't want to spend the money for a large can, they have smaller ones that you can get. And there's a really great selection at Walmart. FYI.
Do you like to put your collection of pumpkins together?
I do.
Yeah.
I actually like to mix the ones that are decorated in with some, plain ones.
And sort of vary the height like you've done this one. I'm just a nice little chunky wood. I love that.
Thank you.
Now, as we move over here.
Let's talk about these. If you want to decoupage something on a large pumpkin and you need a larger item, these are called French leaves. They're actually cheese. You can put your cheese on them.
Yeah.
And I actually bought these at Williams-Sonoma, but you could probably find them online. But this would be a really easy and I think it would turn out really beautiful on a really big one.
I do too. These are beautiful. Okay.
Thank you.
Now we're moving along.
Moving over.
I always like to have a nice scented either apple spice or some kind of fabulous candle.
The candles are all on sale right now at your
different retail
craft stores.
Yeah.
And this is just super simple. You just have to have a nice big bowl and a nice big candle. And I put some of these little twinkle lights in there. You can put that, the little
pack.
Battery pack, you can submerge that underneath all the scatter. If you turn it on, some of them have timers. So you can put it in there and you turn it on the time you want it to come on, and it will come on at that hour every day, and then it'll shut itself off.
Oh, that's a great idea. So, you just upped that candle
and
to
another level. The scatter, you could, if you find, these are just fake, fake apples that I have, but you can use your imagination.
Okay.
You could put tangerines in there, little lady apples, acorns from your yard.
Yeah.
I've just got nuts.
Yeah, that's what you got.
I was going to spray paint some Walmart, some walnuts gold, but I couldn't find any whole walnuts.
Oh, they're not out yet. I think they start putting them out closer to Thanksgiving.
I think you're right, but that would be awesome.
That would be awesome.
Like metallic spray paint, whatever nut it is, it's got to be
put
in
them
the
in there.
Shell.
And most of us have like a clear bowl, so if you've got one, that's a great idea then.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got this great little plate right here behind you.
Yeah, I've had
really
that forever,
pretty.
Just for a little backdrop.
That would be just a pretty little scenario. Okay, now, this is gorgeous. Would you put this in the center of a dining room table?
I would absolutely put it in the center of a dining room table. On your coffee table, the center of your coffee table. And actually, this slice of wood I bought at a craft store. You can actually go and buy these now.
I see.
And all I've done is just put some different colored pumpkins and gourds. You want to put a candle on there. You just use your imagination. And here, in the front, there's a little nest. I've got acorns from my yard.
That little that's full with little acorns from your yard?
Mm-hmm.
That is adorable.
Yeah. Plant an oak tree. That's one of the trees you should plant.
Okay, we're going to tell everybody another tree, but yeah, look at that. Taylor, can you get a shot of that? That's acorns from her yard. That is so cute and just adds.
And you can find those little nests at your craft stores. And I've just, look at this little twinsy. This is a little twinsy.
That is so cute.
Two pumpkins, one stem.
Two pumpkins in one.
I'm just taking some assorted little pumpkins and gourds, and these will last a long time. You get them before Halloween, and they'll last all through the holidays, through Thanksgiving, and some of them being actually cooked. So if you do the acorn squash, you can decorate it with, and then you can eat it. So
now, flowers, you have a way of just displaying your flowers that just make them so extraordinary as well. This is a pumpkin, and how are these flowers staying so pretty and fresh in here?
Well, it's got florist foam in it.
Oh.
The wet, there's the dry styrofoam, and then there's the wet that you use, and you have to soak it for a few hours before you do your floral. But honestly, you could go into the grocery store and get the pumpkin, and all of this floral, except for the Nandina berries, this is all from the grocery.
Is that
you could literally go in to Kroger or Publix or wherever you shop, get, because they have pumpkins.
Oh yeah.
And as long as you have your florist foam at home, and I just cut out, gutted it, and then there's a Ziploc bag in there. That's what's holding the foam.
The foam, that's moist.
Yeah, now don't do these, if you want to do something like these, don't do them until almost right before you're getting ready to use it.
Okay.
Because being a pumpkin, and it'll break down after about 2 or 3 or 4 days.
So if you're going to be using this for an occasion, then just don't do it right until
If you're going to do something like this for your centerpiece, do it like 3 or 4 days.
Okay.
That's about the max.
Okay, now tell me about the one at the end.
The one at the end, I've taken one of those green knobby jobs, and I just, when I was spray painting, there's magnolia in here, and there's also newlyweds, folks. Yeah. If you're going to plant one tree in your yard, make it a magnolia tree.
Magnolia.
It's the gift that keeps on giving all year, because you use the blooms in the spring to decorate with. You can use the leaves all year long. And you see, I've spray painted these with the same gold paint down there with the pumpkin. And these, they were in my yard, and I thought, well, wonder what they'd look like spray painted.
So those came off the magnolia
tree. These are the pods that die. They're all over the ground. So I just picked it up and spray painted, and I think it looks pretty cool.
They really look cool.
Yeah.
What effect did you use to get this sort of like gold leafed on the
pumpkin?
All
I did was just take a brush and just dip it in the gold paint, and just I sprayed some into the in a paper plate, just so I could have a liquid.
Oh.
You don't have to go out and buy more paint. Just spray
the paper plate and just stipple it
a little bit, because it makes it it makes it look a little bit better.
Lisa, you're so good and have so many wonderful ideas, and you're doing some consultations with design.
Yeah.
So
I'm helping some friends or anybody that wants to reach out.
Absolutely.
I love to decorate.
So. You can see we've got her information there on the screen if you'd like to reach out to Lisa Quinn to maybe get a consultation to help her turn your home into a beautiful, beautiful fall scenery like you have here today. I always love seeing you, Lisa. Thank you so much for coming down
today.
You're
so welcome. It's my honor. Happy fall to you.
Thank you. I want to also thank Sue Fort White from our kids for being here as well. And thank you for watching. I'm Tawanda Coleman, and I'll see you next time on The Plus Side of Nashville.